Hi guys, it's Lissa. This is the movie, or not the movie, the look we're going for today. I know I look a little crazy with my tiara on, but a friend is having her wedding on Saturday and asked me to do her makeup. So while I'm kind of getting some, you know, looks together for her to look over and see what she likes, I figured why not make a video and, you know, dress the part. So I have a tiara, why not? I had a white prom dress my junior year of prom, and that was so many years ago. If I would still fit it, I probably would have worn it for the tutorial just for the fun of it, but that would have been a little over the top, don't you think? I don't know. Anyways, we are doing today's makeup look solely with one product, for the eyeshadow anyways, and that is Too Faced, the Natural Eye Palette. Looks like this. And the colors on the inside. There's a lot of shimmer to it. It doesn't really show up too well on the camera. See how sparkly this one is here. This one we put on our brow bone. Oh, it's just so pretty. But I just wanted to talk to you about that. I already did my base makeup, and I'll link the videos below that kind of go over the different things that I used. I didn't do my typical flawless face makeup. I've been using BB cream lately with just a little bit of concealer, so that way my face can clear up. I also use these two products, which I reviewed in a previous video, the Wet n Wild Fergie Edition palettes. One is Rose Champagne Glow and the other is Rose Golden Goddess. And I use the bronzer one below my cheekbone and the more pink one as a highlight around my brow bone and my cheekbone. And also, in addition to highlighting with that, I used an LA Colors palette, which you can just get at the dollar store. And this one is Darling. And I took this pearly white color and just made a more defined highlight, kind of like a C shape around here. Blended it really good with my finger and down the bridge of my nose and over the cupid's bow of your lip. You can use any pearly white highlighter eyeshadow to do that with. You don't have to have, you know, something that's called a highlighter. Just use an eyeshadow. It works the same way. You just want to make sure it's shimmery and kind of has a pearl look to it. So getting back on track with this palette, it's really cool. It comes with several different cards that come out of the side here. I've already taken them out. So it comes with these cards, and my friend, she had her wedding, the September before last, and she wanted me to do her makeup. She said, this is the palette I have. I want you to do the makeup that matches, that's described on this card, and I want you to do it, because she's, I guess, not experienced with blending. I'm not sure why she asked me, but, I mean, everyone likes to be pampered on their wedding, right? So, maybe that's why. So, it wasn't any, you know, really imaginative creative stuff on my behalf. It was just following, this card. But I really liked how the look came out, so that's why I went ahead and mimicked it today, and that's what I have on, and I'm going to show you how to do that. Okay, so first we're going to take our clean crease brush, and I'm mimicking the fashion card. So here's what we're doing, is taking Nude Beach, which is this really pretty nude color, but it's got a lot of sparkle to it. I don't know if the sparkle really shows on the webcam, but we're taking that and just going on our brow bone, and I'm not applying any eye primer to my brow bone, because these colors are already so pigmented and you don't want it to look like, you know, a little too harsh up there. Yeah, I just texted her and she texted me back and she said it was the fashion card that we used. So that's the one I'm doing right now. Next, I'm taking my Mary Kay Signature Eye Primer. I have only tried a few eyeshadow primers, and this one of the few I've tried has been my favorite, although I'm sure there's tons of other good ones out there. If you don't have an eyeshadow primer, then concealer works really, really well as well. Okay, next with this flat brush, looks like this, I'm going to pick up Honey Pot, which is this gold color, and put it on the eyelid and the inner tear duct, just following what the fashion card says. So, I'm not making any of these looks up, I'm not taking credit for making them up, because I'm not. I'm just following the guideline, doing what I did for my friend's makeup look. Okay, taking a clean small crease brush, I'm picking up that same golden color Honey Pot and just drawing it on the inner tear duct here in this inner corner. You guys can see. And the next last step, it is so simple, is just taking this color Cocoa Puff, this bottom corner. It's really, it's very chocolatey brown color, obviously, with some gold speckles to it. We're going to put it in our crease and along the lash line, the upper and lower lash line, and that's going to account for our eyeliner here. this kind of windshield wiper motion back and forth in the crease. And then I'd like to do a little bit, kind of like a V as it goes down to the lash line. I don't like to just stop up here and then go down to the lash line. I like to connect it a bit. Kind of, it just, you know, runs along better. I don't think these were the colors we used on her during her wedding. She says it's what they are, but I don't remember using gold on her at her wedding. But can't say for sure. I really thought we did classic. I'm going to do both of them anyway, so. Okay, get a large crease brush. I'm going to clean off any extra color that's on it and just blend this. I look like Sophia Grace, don't I? Yeah, that was cheesy. I won't burst out singing though, promise. Next, I'm taking my small angled brush, which I also use to do my eyebrows. Pick up that same Cocoa Puff color, and we're going to basically do our eyeliner with it. From about the inner corner all the way to the out. And see that V there that we already drew when we connected the crease down to the eye? That kind of adds to like the cat eye effect. So that works out. I'm going to clean up any fallout. Just brush it off with a clean, large brush. And there is a lot of glitter, not a lot, I guess there's some glitter fallout on my face from the Nude Beach shadow we put on our brow bone. So if you don't like that, then I'd recommend just doing your eyes first and then doing your face makeup last. So that way you can just take a makeup remover pad and just wipe it off. But if you don't mind having a little sparkle around the rest of your face, then there you go. Okay, so next I'm going to line my lower lash line with the Cocoa Puff as well. And I'm making it thicker on the outer, outer half. Okay, next step is to curl your lashes. Heat up your curler on low heat with your hair dryer, and that way it'll give more curl and more oomph to it. Just like when you flat iron your hair. You can't flat iron your hair when it's cold. It has to be hot. So you don't want it to be so hot that it's going to burn your skin if you accidentally touch your lid. So kind of test it with your fingers before you crimp your lashes. And you'll see a big difference in the curl. And then just as how you finish curling your hair, for example, you spray it with hairspray to make it stay. Think of the mascara as hairspray for your lashes. It's going to make that curl stay. Taking my Illegal Length mascara from Maybelline. If you're going to wear false lashes, then this is the one I prefer to use because it's not really thick. You don't want to make your lashes thicker than the false lashes, but you don't want them to be really thin either. You want them about the same width. So this kind of makes them blend together well. I don't like combing mascara through false lashes. I think that just ruins the look of them and it just makes them look stupid and synthetic. I think it just makes them really obvious, like in a fake way. So that's why I just comb this through my real lashes first. A lot of people will disagree and they think it looks better when you comb mascara through your lashes and false lashes, but that's just, I guess, based on personal opinion. You do need to curl your lashes because otherwise you'll have like your lashes going at this curl and then the false lashes going at this curl and you'll have these double layer of lashes and then it'll be really obvious. But whenever I curl them with heat and then apply this mascara before the false lashes themselves, they blend together and you cannot see any, you know, different layers and it's not obvious. They just look so much more natural that way. But try it a couple different ways and see which you prefer. I'm not here to tell you which one you have to do. And I go into more detail on that in my false lashes tutorial. And I'll post that link below. It talks about how to, you know, take care of your lashes as well. Not take care of them, but prepping them for false lashes too. It's, you know, not just about how to apply false lashes. It's really detailed. Next, I'm taking my Ardell Natural 106 lashes that have already been trimmed to fit my eye. They've had quite a bit of uses at them and they're still lasting, but probably here within the next couple uses they're going to be dead, I would guess. They're starting to look a little dead. And I don't like to use them too much because, you know, you're just reusing something that has germs on it. Even though your own germs are still germs.
You can see the glue is still wet, but you can see a little bit on camera how big of a difference it makes. See when I turn to the side?
you can't see a whole separate layer of lashes sticking straight down because they're curled really well with that heat. And then with the mascara, it blends them really well. So, I mean, I know it's kind of far away. You'll see it better in a photo I'll take. And then you can see how nice it works. My L'Oreal Voluminous Waterproof Mascara. I use waterproof on my lower lashes no matter what kind of mascara it is, just because throughout the day, even if you're not crying, throughout the day it's going to smudge, and that's why you want waterproof. Anything waterproof around your eyes is really good, even though it's a pain to get off. But a lot of waterproof mascara tends to be really thick and clumpy, and this one is really thick without the clumpy, so that's why you always see me grabbing this one. And if I don't use false lashes, then I'll use this on my upper lashes for a lot of volume. I really like it. And if you have a really hard time doing your lower lashes without touching your skin, then you can try this L'Oreal Telescopic Explosion Mascara. It's like this. They have a regular telescopic one with the normal size brush, but this one, the little explosion one, is just this itty bitty little brush, and it's meant for getting those little tiny baby lashes, or the ones in the upper, in the corners, lower lashes. I like that one too. I just prefer this one as far as thickness. So as soon as the glue on these lashes finishes drying, I will take a photo and put it at the end of this. And if I can get a photo of my friend's wedding makeup as well, I will insert it. And let me know what you think, if you like it, if you don't like it, what you think about Too Faced makeup. I really like their shadows so far. I can't wait to, you know, someday try more of their products. I just don't have the money to right now. So I think this is a really pretty look for a wedding or a date or even just day to day. It's like smoky without being so smoky you can't wear it in the day. So it's really pretty, and I really wish you could see it in person because photos never do justice to how great some of these pigments really are. So anyways, thanks for watching, and if you've got a wedding coming up, congratulations. Tell me about it. Post photos on Instagram and link me to it so I can see how your makeup came out. I love seeing makeup, and I'm just so happy for anybody, you know, who's going through that great time in their life and they want to share it with others. So thanks for watching.
18 with the coolest system. Top town 18 with the coolest system. When he come up in the club, he be blazing up. Got stacks on deck like he's saving up. And he ill, he real, he might got a deal. He pop bottles and he got the right kind of bill. He cold, he dope, he might sell coke. He always in the air, but he never fly coach. She a motherfucking drip, drip, tell her all the trip, trip. When he make a drip, drip, kiss him on her lip, lip. That's the kind of dude I was looking for. And yes, you get slapped if you're looking ho. I said, excuse me, you're a hell of a guy. I mean, my, you're like pelican fly. I mean, you're so shy, and I'm loving your tie. You're like slicker than the guy with a thing on his eye. Oh. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Somebody please tell him who the F I is. I am Nicki Minaj. I'm Maxim Duga. Back cooped up. Jumped
the booster. You got my heartbeat.